Welcome to our drive-by wedding reception. Thank you for coming, and we're super excited to see you.
So from where you are now to the end where we are, we've set along this path four stations, where you'll see pictures like these that tell our story. So play this video at each one of the stops, and we'll tell you the story behind each picture.
And we're super excited to see you guys at the end.
Welcome to Station One. This is where it all begins.
Yeah, so I grew up in Nevada, and when I was 16, my mom and I, we moved to California. So this was when I was the summer of my junior year. And my aunt, she told me about this Trek Pioneer Church athlete, and she told me that I should join to meet more friends, and I was super excited about it.
Exactly. So during that time, we had, every 4 years, we have this track activity, like Aspen was saying, which is a reenactment of the 1800s experience of the pioneers trekking across the plains. And we'd already had our families, so in the moment, it's lots of different friends and families come together, and we form separate little groups. It was all super fun. We'd already established the one I was a part of. And one morning, we were doing practice hikes so that we could get ready for the big one, right? Because this 3 day trek activity that we had in the last 3 days, and it's lots of walking, lots of pushing around a handcart. We did practice hikes, and I think the second or third practice hike, see this beautiful blonde woman step out of the car with her awesome grandpa, and we were like, I mean, I personally was like, who is that? So I was very, very nervous. I don't even think we spoke to each other pretty much the entire day, though.
Yeah.
We just kind of...
We didn't, like, talk, but, like, we definitely looked at each other.
Very true. Yeah. So, but, oh, that's where... I suppose that's the first time we saw each other. And indeed, I was swept. That was well. You're very beautiful.
And then we had the trek a couple... It was, like, in June. And it was 3 days for... how you explained it. Like, we... yeah. We enacted the pioneers, and it was really fun. It was a great experience. We hiked a lot and pushed a cart, like that one. And so
our group was awesome. We had like such a fun time with everyone, and really enjoying it. So there was lots of service going on. And part of that was helping other people that weren't doing as well, or just, you know, helping them out to get up these hills. Yeah. And so, during those treks up the last hill, so there's one final, they called it Testimony Hill, which is like really trying your, you know, your willpower. We were going up this hill, and a big part of it was going down and helping the people, you know, in the line to get up to the very top. So Aspen and I were doing that. We were in the process of helping people getting up the hill when I get up the top of the hill, and everyone's like, where's Aspen? And I was like, I don't know where Aspen is. And Aspen had fainted on, you know, probably just due to dehydration halfway up the hill, around towards the top of the hill. She's helping out a family go up to the top.
It was a good time.
So clearly I couldn't let just that just happen. So I went down and scooped her up with the energy I had and brought her to the top. Just like that one. Not the first date. It was very cute.
Yeah.
Now was the time it felt like we were very connected after that. From then going on.
Yeah.
So that's the story of that one, and we'll see you on the next one when these pictures come up.
Okay. Welcome to Station Two.
So after trek, Aspen and I, you know, really got to know each other a little bit more, and I worked up the courage to ask her out on lots of dates. So we went on dates, like we went ice skating, which was super fun.
We went to Magic Mountain.
Oh yeah, which is the first time we held hands, which was so precious. So cute. So cute. We just really had a blast. We just really went out a lot and really got to know each other. And that was one of my favorite things about Aspen, was just, you know, so open to just see what we were all about, know what we liked to do, what we didn't like to do, and know who each other was as a person. Mm-hmm. And crowning event with that was definitely prom for us, where we just had the best night ever, and that was definitely a solidifying moment for us, and just knowing, like, I might be the one, I really like her. Aww. But just had a really awesome, my senior year, Aspen's junior year, and they were just moving along happy.
Yeah. And so Joel, he was graduating from high school. This was 2017. And I had to finish my senior year. And so Joel, he got called to the Dominican Republic. Mm-hmm. And so there was lots of things up in the air.
There were lots of things up in the air. And Aspen was figuring out college, figuring out mission for herself, and we were definitely in the midst of things. So, travel on next to the third station where we will talk to you a little bit more. So, welcome to station 3. You made it. You're almost there. We're very excited to see you. So, we've just left off in our story where I've just graduated high school. We're going into the summertime. And the day after I graduated high school, I got my mission call to the Dominican Republic, like Aspen said. And very excited, but need to save up some money. So, during the summer, Aspen and I dated. I worked a lot doing extra work through Central Casting, which was absolutely awesome. I loved working a little bit with Brother Cox through Vivint, doing solar, which was exponentially awesome. And I worked with Brother Clark a lot as well on his house a little bit, which was super fun. I worked with a guy named Brenton, and he was just so fun and just a really good time. So I was saving up money, enjoying my last little bit of summer. Mm-hmm. And yeah, just Aspen and I were dating that whole time, which is super fun.
Yeah, and so at the end of the summer, Joel left for Dominican Republic, and I had my whole entire senior year to do, and it was a great year. I was involved like doing track, and I was involved with our church group, and it was a good year. It definitely felt different than my junior year, like not having Joel around, but it was awesome because we got to email each other once a week and tell each other how we're doing, and I loved hearing from him and like his stories. So it was a really neat time, like we were growing closer even though we were apart.
It's true, because it was a good 2 years. Like I knew for at least 2 years we weren't going to see each other because I was going to be out in the Dominican Republic. So it was really fun for me to see Aspen's senior year of high school and even going into college, getting lots of pictures, lots of fun. Aspen at one point went on a cruise with your mom. And she took this fun picture where we were like, you could see on the map, we were so close. Like, I was in Mexico, where were you? Like, Cozumel?
Mexico.
She was in Mexico.
Belize,
In Belize. It was super close, but yet so far. It was super fun. But it was good to keep, like, going from, like, in such a dating aspect of our relationship to transitioning into a more like focusing on the get to know you, like, a little bit more than we already had. Mm-hmm. And it was really enjoyable as well. I was doing good things, Aspen was doing good things, you know, just progressing, which is so awesome. And then I get an email one day from the Miss Aspen. About how?
Yeah, so I went up to Idaho and I went to college for one semester, like fall 2018. And then I decided to go on a mission. And that meant we wouldn't see each other for 3 years. Mm-hmm. That's a long time, not gonna lie. So then I got called to the Oregon Eugene mission.
She did. So communally between the two of us, Aspen's 18 months, year and a half to my 2 years, I lined up so it would be 3 years, like Aspen said. And 3 years is a long time without being able to see each other. And here I was the whole time thinking, well, like, now Aspen's gonna be by herself dating lots of guys, what am I gonna do, you know? When I get home, at least I'll be right there to get her. Then it switched to, I'm going to be home by myself. I'm going to be home by myself, and Aspen's going to be on her mission. But at least I knew she was going to be safe, so that was comforting during those 2 times.
Yeah.
And of course, we're doing service, we're preaching the gospel, doing as missionaries, so, you know, lots of good things. So yeah, Aspen's on her mission.
Yes.
And then, yeah, that takes us
to the next station. Okay, so this is the last station and the last part of our story. So we just left off how Joel was on his mission in Dominican Republic, and I did a semester at BYU Idaho, and I got my mission called to the Oregon Eugene mission. And so that meant for us, like, we went to see each other for a very long time. And so I went to Oregon and I had a wonderful time and I loved it so much. And I was there for a year, and that's when COVID started like happening, and they started sending missionaries home, with any like health problems. And so I went home after being in Oregon for a whole year, and I came home and Joel came home from, he was up in Idaho too. So he came home from college and we started talking again.
It was lovely. It was fun. So I was up in Idaho, just like Aspen was saying, and with COVID and everything, it just felt like the right choice to come home. And then I found out that Aspen was going to be home, which is a surprise for me, because you know, you'd only been out a year, and I was still waiting the extra 6 months. I was like, well, I gotta wait. So I was very excited to come home. And in my head, all along the drive home, I was just like, oh, I can't wait to see Aspen. Like, I was in the car with Dad, and we're talking, and I was like, I want to see you today. But Dad's like, you're going to be really tired when you get home. Probably see you tomorrow. So I did. So I waited a day. Came home that Saturday, that Sunday. And then, well, we started dating that next Tuesday.
Like, I literally, like, came home Wednesday. And then you came home, like, Saturday night. And we saw each other Sunday. And then we just, like, hung out.
Just hung out?
All the time. It was really sweet. It was a special time.
It was cool to pick up where we left off. Everything seemed to just flow so perfectly, like we were together but we were separate, and when we came together it was a sweet reunion. So we did that, so we're together at last, right? But yes, of course we gotta save up, make money, and
yes,
get jobs, everything. So Aspen started out with,
yeah, so this was in March when this was happening,
when you got home.
Yeah, yeah. When I got
and we started dating and everything.
We started dating again of this year, and then yes, I got a job at Topper's Pizza as a delivery driver. Super fun. And you got a job as a construction worker.
Yep.
So
working for Ford the Construction. Super fun.
Yeah.
So when I came home from my mission, actually, I worked a little bit with Ford, which was awesome. Get to know it a little bit more. Went to school, came back, and I was lucky enough to get another job with them again. Great company. I'm having so much fun with them. And we've been doing that up until right now. And we're still, Aspen's still toppering.
I'm still doing
construction, having a great time, saving up money.
Yeah.
It's been great. But during all this time, of course, we're planning, we're talking, we're trying to figure things out. We both come to the conclusion that, you know, this is a person we want to spend the rest of forever with.
Forever.
We did lots of talking before I proposed. We did lots of dating and getting to know each other, and, you know, the marriage popped in, of course, is a question. And you know, we really felt like together, we prayed about it and everything, that was the right decision. We wanted a trip to Yosemite, Yellowstone, sorry. We went up to Yellowstone, and it was like the first time Aspen and I really been on a trip together. You know, apart from Trek, which was at the very beginning, of course. And it was super fun to just really mesh. I'd be with her family and us all together, and I think that was really where it felt like, no, we can make this work. Like, we can do it.
Yeah.
So, what happened then, Effie?
And then we started talking about getting married, and we actually got a ring up in Rexburg.
Yeah, on the way home from that trip, bought the ring there.
So,
really fast.
That was really fun. Yeah. But then we came home, and then we started, kept dating, and then Joel proposed.
Woohoo!
That was so cute. And you proposed at Bridgeport. It was actually really cute. We love Cheesecake Factory. It's like so good, especially like the salted caramel cheesecake. So good. So we ordered Cheesecake Factory on the phone, and there was gonna be like a 20-minute wait. And so Joel was like, do you wanna go to Bridgeport, where we can go somewhere really cool by my house? And I was like, let's go to Bridgeport because it's a super pretty place. So Joel made me feel like I was like choosing to go to this place. And so we show up to Bridgeport, and like it's a really pretty lake area, like a pond kind of, but it's pretty big and it's beautiful. And there's this little, what is it called? Like a walk.
Pier.
Yeah, a little pier. And I see this little archway, but my first thought was, oh my goodness, someone's getting married. I didn't even think anything about us two. Like, I didn't think about it. And so Joel was like, yeah, let's go check it out. And I was like, okay. And then we start walking, and I was like, wait, what if someone is like, needs to be here? Anyways, I was just like, I didn't even think about it. And so then Joel got on his knee and he asked me to marry him. And I said, yes, a million yeses. But so that was really, really cute. No, it reminded me of Tangled. That was like the big thing. It was so cute because there was like lanterns in the lake and it was really cute.
I'm glad you really liked it. Yeah, it was fun. That was, so Jacob Betson and I, so he and I, we went to the lake earlier that day and we started setting this thing up. And so many like people were like watching and being like, what's going on here? And like the security guard even comes, he's like, you allowed to do this? And I'm like, yes, I'm allowed to do this. I'm like, I'm just gonna propose, you know, and I'll be right out. And he's like, oh, that's so awesome. Like his countenance totally changed from like, you're not supposed to be here too. Oh, like, yeah, take as much time as you want. I think he was happy it wasn't two young men just being silly. So that was good. But super grateful for Jacob because we set it all up. We put the lights on it and everything. Really worked hard. Yeah, I went to go pick Aspen up and planned it perfectly, like Aspen was saying.
It was perfect. It was a total surprise.
Very proud of it. We did lots of driving around, just kind of like, oh, where's a good spot be for Bridgeport? And we're just driving around, and I'm like, in the back of my head, of course, I'm like, I know exactly where we're going. So we go up. I was like, oh, I know. Like, well, let's go over here. So we pull in, and it was that moment when Aspen just said, she was like, oh, look, did you see that? Someone's getting married. In the back of my head, I had to turn away from Aspen to park to just smile and just not laugh, like just hold it in. the irony. And right then we hopped out, walked down, and it was perfect. Got to ask Aspen to marry me. She said yes.
Yes.
And then what happened?
And then after we got married, well, we got cheesecake after that.
Yeah, but we got dinner, FaceTime our family. Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Special. But then after we were engaged, we had to figure out a date to get married. And so, but it was a crazy time because there was a lot of unknowns, like when should we get married and where, and especially with the COVID restrictions, we didn't know, there wasn't a lot of options open for us. A lot of the temples in California were like closed, and it was crazy from the beginning. We just did not know what to do.
So we decided on, and just like I've been saying, we decided hopefully the end of December would be a good time. Yeah.
That was like our idea, like at the end of December.
No idea, right? We were like, you know, be right before school starts, we can go up to school together, and it'd be great. And then we decided a little bit earlier, you know, like we'll do end of November, you know? And then Emily, my sister, got her mission call. And the way things worked out with home MTC and everything, her last day here in at home was gonna be November 10th. So we're like, well.
And we really wanted Emily to be here, like for the wedding.
Of course.
And so
we decided November 7th was the perfect day.
Yeah.
And that was definitely a lot of foretelling. It was great. So that'll come into play later. So, of course, is the where, right? Where are we gonna get married? LA Temple's closed, Newport Temple's open, but it's closed for cleaning or renovations or something or other. We even thought, like at one point, we're like, maybe we'll get in Utah. Like one of us would have to like move to Utah and like live there for a little bit.
But that sounded like.
It sounded like cheating away. So we just decided overall, we're like, all right, San Diego. So San Diego's a special place and they were open for the time being. So we got an awesome scheduled date. Like a month before, or like a month and a half before.
Yeah. And I went to Utah for my bridal shower, like with my family.
Yes.
And then Joel called and was like, oh my goodness, the San Diego like decided to close the temple. So that was like so stressful. That was like literally a month before.
We were about to get married. Everything's coming to this point. And just like, they called me and they're like, that's it. Like, you can get married in 2 days from now. But like on what was like a Wednesday, they're like, Wednesday, it's gonna be closed.
Yeah, and we didn't know how long it was gonna be closed for.
But we kept a good attitude. Yes. We just kept working on. We're like, all right, well, we'll figure it out. It makes sense in the end. And luckily, my Uncle Byron and with the lovely, awesome San Diego State Temple Presidency and everybody, we all figured it out and finally came together and got the date back.
Yeah, and they opened the temple up, so it was perfect.
Exactly. Yeah, we opened the temple, got it all going again. Yeah. But of course, the big question is, marriage license, right? How do we get that? And because with COVID and everything and lots of restrictions in the government buildings and everything, the earliest appointment, like for a lot of these places near us, was like January to even December, be looked at. December, January to even be looked at for a wedding license. So we're like, what are we gonna do? So Aspen, like a champion, called every single county.
We
finally got a hold of Fresno, huh?
Yeah.
Also Santee down in San Diego as well.
Yeah.
But then with the help of Dad and everybody, we finally got Fresno.
It was like the earliest one we could get. And it was like a week before the wedding.
week before the wedding, right?
It was
so we both took time off from work. We both hopped in mom's car and we headed on over to Fresno. The drive was much longer than the actual visit. Probably took around like 20 minutes in the actual government building. They're like, all right, yeah, that's it.
It was like super fast.
Like, oh, that's it. They made it so easy for us. So that was nice.
So, but it was a tender mercy, like being able to get our marriage license before the wedding, and everything just like fell into place. Even though there were so many unknowns, we just didn't know like how it was gonna happen, but we trusted.
And that brought us right to November 7th. We got married, we got sealed.
It was
everything
a beautiful
turned out
day.
Great. Yeah. Photographers were awesome, our families were awesome. Set everything up so beautiful here at home as well.
Yeah, so we got married in San Diego in the morning, this beautiful temple, and then we drove back here to Valencia and we got married in the backyard. We have a beautiful like ring ceremony with our families, and it was really special.
And it's fun to know now, because then we got to go on awesome
Yeah.
A honeymoon. We went to Cancun, Mexico, which was super great. We went there for a whole week.
It was really fun.
And upon reflection, like, San Diego Temple closed. Mm-hmm. Like, it was November 7th, I think November 10th, it closed.
Like, literally a few days after we got married, it shut down again, so.
So, in the end, we just kind of felt very, very lucky, very grateful, and very fortunate, because everything seemed to just fall into place. Honeymoon, wedding, it all just was... Definitely turned out for the best.
So now we're just working at like toppers and construction, and we're planning on going to BYU Idaho in January.
Very excited. Yes. And then from then, our happily ever after. Yes.
Thank you so much for coming, and we're super excited to see you.
You're almost there. We're super excited to see you. All right.
Bye.
Bye.